Yes, sir, we promised you a great main event here tonight.
Andre, the Giant.
WrestleMania.
Hulkamania is running west.
My God, what a
big thing. Of course, this was the shock of the night. This was the excitement of the night, the overjoyment of the night, so much that I've gone back and looked at this moment throughout the day, since the morning till I was in class looking up this moment. The Hardy Boys came back. We're gonna cover this entire thing. It's a lot to cover. It's very exciting. I'm excited for Raw tonight. Raw's going to cover that. There's a lot to cover with WrestleMania, with wrestling alone. There's a lot to cover. But Rob Core, let me tell you something, man. Let me tell you something. The Hardy's coming back. I mean, it was one of those things where it was rumored for weeks and years. Oh, they're coming back this time. They're coming back. We hear it so many. We would hear it so often that I was just like, yeah, whatever. I'm not going to believe it. If they come back, if they do, if they don't, whatever. It got to the point where I was kind of irritated. Because, you know, I was waiting for so long for the Hardys to finally come back. And I'm jumping the gun a little bit. I know. So, the New Day, they come out and they announce, oh, this is now going to, I've just been worried that there's going to be a Fatal 4-Way. But, you know, who team is it going to be? And everyone's like, whoo. And it starts slowly walking towards the ring. And you think it's going to be the New Day. They have the gear on and they look ready to go. You're thinking, nah, it's going to be New Day. Which I wouldn't have been upset with if they would have been joined into this tag team match. But a sudden sound. A sudden noise just pierced my eardrums as I slowly looked at the TV. It was like a sudden urge of joy that I haven't felt in such a long time. I felt myself as a kid again when I heard this familiar sound. I can't play the whole song because I don't want to be copyrighted, but that, just that sound alone, that little, those two, those couple little bass, that little, just that little bass sound right there. Oh my gosh, let me tell you something, man. Rob Core, let me tell you something. The Hardys coming back was one of the greatest things that's happened in a long, long time. I take it back. AJ Styles debuting was just as great as this. But just, oh man, I felt like a kid again. I was screaming. I was ecstatic. I couldn't believe it. I couldn't freaking believe it. Me and my friend beside me, my family, everyone. I was with my brothers, my family, my friends. And watching this, I couldn't believe my ears. I couldn't believe my eyes. I couldn't believe what I was feeling inside. It just, this over excitement that I had for this. The Hardy Boys back into the WWE is that's gonna be one of the greatest things that's happened in a long time for this company. And they went on into this tag team match. It was a good fit of a four-way ladder match. I personally would have liked if this would have been a little bit longer. Hardys aside, I want to say that Cesaro and Sheamus are really, really good together. I didn't think that this was going to be a good thing down the line. I was one of those people who was like, this is stupid. I take it back. I've seen these two for a while, and seeing them again here in this Fatal 4-Way, Cesaro and Sheamus are really, really good together. They really are, and I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Cesaro was great, and I used to give Sheamus a lot of crap. Sheamus could be world champion tomorrow, and I wouldn't be upset about it, because something about him teaming up with Cesaro just made him a better performer overall, and I love it. I really, really am liking, I'm digging Sheamus, I'm digging Cesaro, I'm digging them as a team, their whole gimmick with the agent, the 007 thing with Cesaro, and then the Scottish thing with Sheamus. I'm digging it. I'm loving it so very, very much, and they were great in this as much as the Hardys, and, you know, as for the club, I love them because the Bullet Club, AJ Styles, Finn Balor, the Young Bucks, and then Gallows and Anderson, I love all of them. They're getting out shine. It's not their fault. It's just it's a little too late with, you know, them getting the titles, and because most of the summer they weren't booked correctly, and you know, when people that we love aren't booked correctly, it does affect how we see them and how much we care, according to Dolph Ziggler. But all that aside, this was a great match. Different spots that happened in here. We had at one point Big Cass throwing Enzo over the ladders to attack Gallows. That was pretty cool. We had like Jeff and Matt doing the poetry in motion and all their old tag team stuff they used to do back in the day. That was pretty cool. There was a spot where Cesaro hit like a European uppercut to Enzo Amore. There was a cool thing Cesaro did where he like slingshotted Gallows to Sheamus, and Sheamus caught him, turned it into a power slam. Again, I'm a guy who likes moves or who likes seeing different moves in a match, and I like looking at different stuff. So I'm going off of some of the stuff I saw and some of the stuff I liked, and I thought that was one of the things that I thought was pretty cool to me. Sheamus did a couple like five miscarry rolls to Gallows and Anderson. Those were pretty cool. And then, you know, the finale, pretty much, Matt Hardy at 42 years old hit a leaping twist of fate off the ladder onto the ground. Looked like he hurt himself a little bit. Looked like he got hurt his head, but he was fine afterwards. And Jeff Hardy then hit a Swanton Bomb off the 14-foot ladder onto Cesaro and Sheamus. Of course, he didn't get Sheamus all the way, but it doesn't matter. It was still beautiful. And Matt Hardy and Jeff Hardy, Brother Nero, Broken Matt. We'll see how the whole Broken Matt character will work on Monday Night Raw tonight, if they will keep it or they're Team Extreme, whatever. They are now the Raw Tag Team Champions, which is great. I think even tonight, I don't want to jump the gun and spoil what I think will happen on the night after WrestleMania, the Raw after Mania, but I think we will get Gallows and Anderson versus the Hardys tonight, and we will see. We will see. But this was a great match. Again, another match that I felt it was too short. I felt like this could have went a lot longer. But the end result was the Hardys won the championships. So it is okay. The only thing I have to say about this and the Hardys coming back is Mattel and 2K better step up their game. I better see the Hardys Mattel figure. I want a Hall of Fame flashback elite series of the Hardys coming out soon. And I want 2K18 to feature the Hardys with Kurt Angle. Oh, I can't wait. Let me tell you something, man. We're going to calm down a little bit. We're going to get to the rest of the matches that's on this card. But I'm going to give this match a solid 3.5. out of 5 because it was too short and I felt it could have been longer, but it was great to see the Hardys back. Don't question my grading system, whatever.